and today we are going to talk about how to work with shapes. Actually, it is not only a Microsoft Word tutorial, but you can also use the same procedures and commands in Excel and PowerPoint. This topic is going to be a little long, so instead of creating a single 2 or 3 hours video, I am going to divide it into separate chapters, so that you can easily pick and choose the desired lesson and subject of your choice from the playlist. In this first chapter, we are going to cover some basic steps of inserting and working with shapes. To start working with shapes, you need to move to the Insert menu, and when you click the Shapes drop-down button, then here you can find certain predefined shapes types like lines, rectangles, basic shapes, flowcharts, callouts, and many more. You can click and select whatever predefined shape that you would like to draw. Then move your mouse pointer to the page area where you would like to draw that shape. Then start dragging by holding down the left mouse button and then release the button after having an appropriate size. You can notice a change in the menu bar where you have a new format menu under Drawing Tools, which holds all the necessary commands to work more efficiently with shapes. And that is what I was talking about before. To teach you all these formatting commands like resizing, positioning, wrap text, grouping, and many other commands, I will upload separate video of each subject because most of these commands need vast discussion, so you may clearly understand the exact use of each command. So, the first thing you should keep in your mind is that you will only see the format menu if at least one shape is selected. Like if I unselect the shape by clicking inside the blank area of the page, then in an instant the format menu will disappear. In Word 2007 and later versions, certain menus only appear while working with certain types of objects. Like Design and Layout menu under Table Tools will appear when you will be working inside the tables. It is important to remember because you might be struggling to find out the format menu, whereas the problem could be that no shape has been selected. Select a shape and there you have the format menu back at place. Another interesting thing that you might like about shape is, if you choose any shape from the insert menu and just click inside the page instead of drawing the shape by dragging the pointer, then Word will automatically draw a fixed size shape for you. Most of the time, like for rectangles, oval or other basic shapes, the fixed size will be 1x1 in height and width. And for other shapes, it could be anything varying from shape to shape. To adjust the size of a shape, select that shape and then hold down and drag the circles which appears around the shape when you select it. Then drag outward to increase the size and inward to decrease the size. If you want an exact proportion of the shape, means height matching with width or vice versa, then always increase or decrease the size by dragging and dropping from the corners. When you drag an object from the corners either to reduce or increase the size, then Word will automatically maintain the width and height proportions, so the object may not look like stretchy or shrunk. You can easily move shapes by first selecting the shape and then move your mouse pointer in the center. And when the four-sided arrow appears, you can drag and drop the shape to the new place. With certain shapes, you might also see a yellow point that you can use to easily redesign or edit the shape style. And you can see that how quickly you can change or redesign a shape style. When a shape gets selected, you may see three options alongside the shape, which are layout options, rotation, and anchor point. We will talk about anchor point in later videos. Let's first see the rotation. After selecting a shape, you can see the rotation point on the top of the shape with a curved arrow. It is actually a free rotation point and you can hold and roll over to freely rotate an object to any degree you like. Do note, when rotating shapes, the rotation or reference point by default and always will be in the center of the shape, and you cannot define a reference point at the time of rotation. That means while rotating an object, the object will always be rotating from its center point. Another interesting feature that you might find useful while inserting shape is holding down the Shift key. Choose a shape from the Insert menu and before dragging and drawing the shape, which will then draw an equally proportioned shape, means the shape will have an equal height and width. Not only that, if you hold down the Shift key while dragging a line, it will constrain its angle to be 180 degrees. So, it could be very useful when you need an equally proportioned shape or straight line without having a shift in the angle. The another keyboard shortcut that you might found handy while dragging or resizing shape is holding down the Ctrl Alt Shift keys. So, while drawing a shape, if you hold down Ctrl Alt and Shift keys, then it will draw the shape in equal ratio from all the sides. The same applies while resizing a shape. If you hold down those three keys while resizing a shape, then it will increase or decrease the size in equal ratio from all the sides. This shortcut could be really useful, let's say when you need to draw a circle of large or small size within the same proportion. For instance, I draw a circle here and remove the fill color from the format menu. Now, I copy and paste the same shape once and then drag and drop it over the previous one. Now, I hold down the Ctrl, Alt and Shift keys and can drag in or outward to exactly maintain the proportion with the previous shape. To easily duplicate a shape, you can first select that shape and then hold down the Ctrl key. A small plus sign will appear along with the mouse pointer. If you will now drag and drop the shape to the new location, it will instantly create a copy of that shape. Another trick that you might found useful while copying shapes is, when you need to copy a shape and paste it alongside with exact alignment of 180 degrees, then hold down both Ctrl and Shift keys and then place the shape to the new location. Word will then copy and align the new shape at 180 degrees. In Word 2016, when you insert a shape inside a new document, it is filled with blue color with a black outline, which is the default settings for new shapes in new documents. But let's say that you need to draw a few rectangles of different sizes with no fill color in them. With the default setting, you have to choose no fill for each shape that you will draw. So, what you can do to change the default settings for the particular document? First, draw the shape and then choose the desired fill and line color that you want. Then, right-click on the shape and choose Set as Default Shape. Now, again draw a new shape and it will have the new default fill and line color setting that you had specified. But remember that the custom default setting will only work in this document. Shapes filled with colors can easily be selected by moving pointer between the shape. But those shapes having no fill color have to be selected by moving the pointer near to the outline. Before we end this chapter, let's see a few more basic commands that you might need to use on routine basis. When you need an exact size of a shape, then you can define custom size in inches from the format menu through size section. Here, you can define the shape height and width in inches. Remember that by default, log aspect ratio is enabled for sizes. That means if you will change the height, then width of the shape will get automatically resized and vice versa. That is to maintain the exact proportion of the shape, so the height matches the width and width matches the height, and the shape may not look stretchy. However, you can turn off log aspect ratio by opening size window and then uncheck log aspect ratio option. Now you can have different height and different width of your shape. Previously, in this chapter, we had talked about free rotation, but if you want to rotate a shape at specific angle, then you can do this by clicking on Rotate drop-down button from the Format menu, and then click More Rotation Options. Below, you can specify an exact angle of rotation and then apply the changes. So, this was a basic introductory lesson on working with shape. In next lesson, we will learn about wrapping text around the shape. I hope you will find this video informative. Do leave your comments and don't forget to